Ja, hello und welcome back in Skrieg. With me, Hans Skrieg. Hans Waffe. The Hans... Lufthansa. Wait, Lufthansa. Yeah, they named the whole fucking airline after me. Lufthansa. See? Gunther's so happy. last time we got in some pretty proper dogfights, and I was really happy with how I, maintained my aerial acumen in the face of imminent danger. We got some kills, and, obsolete forward Schwefterferger got promoted to lieutenant behind me. He's not going to be flying with this flight. We have a long flight ahead of us, so use the restroom, if you need to. We're actually going to be taking drop tanks on this one, even though we're right at the front lines, because we have a long flight straight down to the city of Kursk. We're going to be flying essentially a fuck you mission over the city. Fuck you as in, how dare you try and fly in the face of the Fatherland. So, we're going to try to control the city's airspace, even though we don't control the city's ground space. High altitude flight, right around noon, good weather for it too, and we have a large flight. So that's what we're going to be doing today, taking our sweet little drop tanks and hopefully behaving well in another dogfight. Well, I wouldn't mind not having a dogfight. I'm a little dogfighted out right now. I wouldn't mind just sort of being a tour guide, like, and toward your left you will see the statue of the Fatherland, this strudel in his hand, which symbolizes, I don't know what I'm doing with my accent right now, it symbolizes the transformation of the Holy Roman Empire into the demi-Prussian pseudo people. We're gonna go ahead and let the autopilot take care of this stuff. Well, my track IR is all wobbly today. Okay, settle down, Hans. Hans had too much strudel. Oop. There we go. Whoa, everything's going so fast. It's better if I let the autopilot do the takeoffs for me. You've already seen me take off, but this will give me a little bit of a speed advantage, so it won't take quite so long for me to catch up to my flight. And, you know what I'm a little worried about? I don't understand why we haven't been flying with our gun pods. I know you can't fly with your gun pods and your drop tanks at the same time, so that makes sense for this particular mission, but there's been a bunch of anti-bomber and anti-fighter raids that we've gone on where we haven't equipped gun pods, and one of the best things about the 109G6 is the ability to attach gun pods to the wings there. Extra ammo, massive firepower. So, I don't know, I mean, and when it came down to it, I'd much prefer the gun pods to, like, rockets or bombs, for example, so, hopefully, we don't have any control over our ordnance right now. If we're given command of a wing or something like that, Jesus, calm down, don't fly so close together. Where's my other, we've got another two guys that should be with us, there they are, oh, I guess it's more than two. Unless those are enemies come to shoot us in the face. Alright, we're nearing Kursk. It's, it's out there somewhere. I can't. Oh well. 3,600 meters. Now, normally at this altitude you'd want to be playing with the fuel mixture, but this plane does everything automatically. Fighters at 12 o'clock. Okay. Whoa. That was harrowing. Alright, let's see if I can stay with my wing here. I don't know what the fuck he's doing. Looks like he decided to stall himself out. And because of that wonkiness with the autopilot, I don't really know where my targets are, where my friendlies and my enemies are. So I'm just going to stay with this guy here, if I can. Oops. Looks like this is all our flight. There's an airfield over there that I'm seeing. Yep, those are also ours. Yeah, I haven't got a clue where the enemy might be. But, I'm not gonna worry about it too much. Unless they shoot me and kill me, and then I'll be really worried. because we're way in enemy lines. Also, everybody else has dropped their tanks. I'm pretty sure. Let me just check. My autopilot might have already dropped mine. Yeah, we already dropped our tank. Okay. Man, get down here, fool. My engine can't keep up with yours, you big jerk. And we're getting anti-aircraft fire now. And still no sign of wherever those fighters were. This plane has got an unbelievably low stall speed, so we can really mess around with gaining altitude. And right now, I'm gonna put my flaps on to try to maintain the altitude that I've gained so I don't do too much dropping. But I do want to keep my eyes open, because somewhere around here there's fighters. They're probably really low. Look at this, we're almost at 5,000 meters right now. I didn't see that indicated in the flight plan at all. I thought 3,000 was going to be our max altitude. Unless we're trying to match something. I suppose if the enemy fighters are at a similar altitude, then that makes sense, but I have, as of yet, seen hide nor hair of them. We're going quick enough, I don't need those anymore. Yeah, I don't really know. I get this feeling, though, that we're just going to be heading home. It looks like we're heading to a waypoint, unless something up there, unless those are enemies up ahead of us, which I'm doubtful. Either way, we are kriging that way! Oh, you know what? Something up there is an enemy. Yeah, they're doing maneuvers. Okay, so there's bad guys up there somewhere. Which ones are which? I suppose we're gonna find out in a minute here. I'm gonna try to maintain a sort of steady flight path here, because I don't wanna lose too much altitude until I've been able to identify which ones of these guys are bad men. Okay, that's a 109. Seven's got... Uh-oh. Alright, well, whatever they are, they're deadly. So, no fucking around. Unfortunately, they're all kind of above me. That one is an enemy plane. Those bullets are not German. Yeah, eight's toast. I need to be real careful here. Because... Alright, I'm going to try to come under this guy here. I don't think he's going to come down to my level, but I do have some good speed. I don't know if I want to burn it, though, getting up there. I would have to burn a lot of speed getting up to that guy's level, and there could be an enemy on me at any moment now, just diving down. Alright, let's see if we can get a shot on this guy. Coming from underneath him. Uh-oh. He knows I'm here. His spider sense was tingling. Yeah, he's gonna get so much speed here. Oh, look at all that speed he got. Ooh! And he just got plonked. Oh yeah, he's toast. Our guys are getting some loving on him. That is a yak. I can tell by the pixels, and having seen quite a few yaks in my day. God, I just got so disoriented right there. There's a point in this plane where you can't turn your head anymore upwards. I'm losing altitude. One just got a kill. See a plane there. Don't know what he's doing. Hopefully crashing. No, that's a 109. Alright, right now I need to keep my eye on my tail, because I think this fight is pretty much over. But if it's not, then I'm the one that's in trouble. That's a 109. Square elevators. That's an enemy plane. I think. I don't know. I know that one here's got somebody on him. Yep. Oh, you're gonna play that game? Alright. Ooh, boy. Yeah, he's definitely gonna play this game. Come on. Oh, crap! What the fuck? That's one of ours. Where's the fucking yellow? Jesus. You're such a fucking idiot. Why the hell did he do that maneuver with me on his tail? Well, obviously he thought I was gonna shoot him, and I did. I thought anybody that was willing to do that maneuver must be an enemy. I didn't really get a good look at him, though. Fortunately, I didn't hit him very hard. None of my big cannon rounds managed to nail him. Well, this flight's going really well. So far, I can't find any enemies, only shooting my friends. So there's Kursk. Kursking it up down there. Alright. I saw by the tracers that I think this guy might be an enemy. I'm not going to really be able to catch him, though, because of how much speed he's got coming out of that dive. And I want to be really careful not to shoot at one of my friends. Yeah, I think that is an enemy. I think it is. So long as my tail is not filled with enemy fighters, I suppose I could be in a position to pursue this. He's gonna do a turny thing. I'm gonna do a turny thing. I'm gonna do an attorney at law. And I'm gonna get real close before I shoot at this guy. Uh-oh. Two just got one. I'm pretty sure my tail's clear. All I gotta do is catch up to this guy. That's all. No big deal. I don't know who's dead and who's not dead in my flights. Okay. Oh, crap. I'm getting my planes mixed up. This is the guy I'm tailing right here. Engine's overheating. I'm fine with that. He's coming up on one of my guys who just took out one of his guys. So good. We're in the leapfrog right now. Unfortunately, he's really fast. I got your back. Uh-oh. Hold it together. Whoa. Alright. Oh, come on, cannons. Come on. We gotta save my buddy. I'm gonna get lower, because it looks like my buddy's gonna go low, and he's gonna follow. So if I hit the deck first, we should be able to get an advantage. Or not. Yes, we will come out of this hot. Unfortunately, I don't know if I'm going to be able to save six in time. Yeah, that guy got him, though. Yeah, I'm so much slower than this guy. What the f... Careful, dude. That is a 109 in front of me. That's one. One must have killed him. Unless... Yeah, oh my god, I almost shot my own guy. The guy we were shooting at a second ago was not, because he was shooting at one of ours. But, okay, that's where that guy ended up. One killed him. And the guy smoking there is one of ours. I don't know. God damn it. Not another one of these ones. Where I fly around for an hour going, what is that? What is that? Oh my goodness. Okay, this guy here, he's flying evasively and he's being shot at by German bullets. You know what that means, right? Party time. Excellent, he's toast. Alright, I think they're all dead. Which means celebration! Whee! Even though we didn't really help. Let's let the autopilot catch up to our formation here. Yeah, we're probably just going to be heading home. Looks like we... I think we lost... Uh-oh. Yeah, six. Six's engine probably just failed. He took quite a few hits and was smoking pretty badly. So I wouldn't be surprised if his engine just failed. Hopefully he's the only one that won't be making it back, though. I know that's harsh. I wish he was making it back, too. I don't think we lost anyone else. relatively uneventful flight for me, except I shot at one of my friends. I hope it wasn't six. I don't think it was. But I don't know. I don't know if I'll ever know. I guess the good thing is that we did some good defensive flying and didn't get anybody directly on our tail. And we didn't run out of fuel. Now all that's left is the landing part. Your favorite. Still paranoid. Alrighty, let's go in for a landing. I don't need my engine. Engines are for girls. With engines. Where's the airstrip? Did I do this a little too early? No, it's over here. Somewhere. There it is. Kind of a bad angle. We should be okay. Where is it? There it is. Okay, I don't see the actual airstrip, but I see that thingy. There it is. Okay. We're good. Yeah, I don't need no engine. Engine, some engine. Where am I? I'm gonna go in for landing, and I'm also still on two-speed time, because I'm a derp. Oh. Overshot it a little bit. Now I'm just hoping I don't need my engine. I'm doing this for cool points. When I get back to the squadron camp, I'm gonna be like, oh yeah? You think you're cool? Landed your plane? I did it without my engine. Biatch. The ground crews are probably like, oh my god, scrambled ambulance. His engine is toast. He'll never land it fine. He can barely land with an engine. We're all gonna die. Yes, my landing gear are down. Oh, look at that. See, it's easier to land. What? One just crashed? His engine might have failed. No! They're fighting someone. Why didn't they call it out? Did I miss it? Where the fuck are they? There's someone right above me. Five is in combat. They might be really far away from me, for all I know. I'm gonna take off again, though, just in case. I hope I have enough runway. No, they're fighting right there, I think. Uh-oh. Stay on the runway. I don't see our guys firing. No, they are firing. I just saw some flak right there. Are there any craters? Because one, wherever one went down, should have left a crater. I don't know, but those guys are heading away from our base. That might have been like a retaliatory raid or something like that. Oh, now I lost them. There they are. What's my fuel situation? Oh, we got plenty of fuel. I can play around with, trying to see if I can pursue these guys and find out what they are. Nope, nope, those are bad guys there. Someone's shooting. Five just got shot down by whoever this guy is. So this guy is alone picking off my wing. And I think he might have just turned around on me. Is he coming right at me? He is, that son of a bitch. Ha ha! Not so funny now, is it? Alright. You wanna play? You wanna be a badass? I'll be a badass too, it's just you and me, buddy. And now you're afraid. God damn, this thing whips around quick. Where'd he go? There he is. Okay. Alright, you're gonna go low, I'm gonna go high. He wants to do a corkscrew with me. Oh, yeah. But I'm going to come down a little bit early. As long as I don't lose him like I just fucking did. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. There he is. Now we're in a scissor. Yep. Ah! I hope I have ammo. Oh, you're so dead. That's what you get for fucking with us. Alright, well, we got vengeance. I didn't get a good kill for that, so that may not... They may not, give me the kill. But I don't really care. I avenged the death of my comrades. So that guy came and followed all the way back to base. And shot down 1 and 5, I believe, were the numbers. After 3:30, so I'm headed back. And he did it alone. He was also brave. Came head on at me. It didn't work out for him, though, because I hit him with a cannon round. I think he probably was expecting me to veer off. Didn't work out for him. He did a good job in the corkscrew, but then I beat him in the scissors. I love dogfights like that. That was brilliant. Makes you feel alive. Especially after doing a crazy landing and then retaking off from base. And then you get to go home a hero. You know, I'm all heroical and shit. And I still got plenty of ammo left, too. So if any more solo jackasses come by, bring it on! I'm a killing machine! I'm just glad I got some action. I thought after all that, I was going to have to go home a loser. What kind of vector did you guys give me? 330, okay. Base should be somewhere right around here. And we're going to go in for another landing. I think I'll use my engine this time, though. Last time not using my engine was, it taunted the powers that be, and they decided to send a vengeful spirit after me. Okay. Let's, speed up time a little bit. It's so hard to see the airstrip. It's like the same color as everything. Can I have permission to land again? Okay, so we saw how well I landed without landing, without my engine. Let's see how well I land with it. Watch, this is going to be a disaster. Yes? Oh man, I was doing it on 2x speed too. What is that? Okay, that guy's not on the runway. My gear are not down. See? So much easier with an engine. Alright! A little bouncier than before. So yeah, we didn't get a kill, and then we did get a kill. Sort of a 2-for-1 mission pack, everybody. I hope you liked it. Where's that? Okay, I really gotta be careful about not running into those frickin' watchtower things. Yeah, that was 2 missions in 1. I took off, I flew a mission, I shot at one of my friends, and then I landed, and then I took off again! Yeah! Alright, let's see how they feel about my missionliness. Oh, Kirshner, 3 kills and was killed. So who was killed near our base? Von Hohenstein. That was an LA-5. He bailed out, so he should be fine. Somebody else was... There's another blue thing here. I see another blue tag under his tag, but I can't see it. Apparently that LA-5 was shot down by Major Kirshner. So, I don't... Okay, this LA-5 was shot down. So he did get a kill. He killed one of them before he was shot. I don't know if he was shot down. Well, he's dead, so I assume that that thing right there... They probably actually collided, because that's why those two markers are the same. Staudinger bailed out, captured, I have no doubt. Lutz. And... yeah, Lutz didn't make it. Those were P-40s we were flying up against over here, and they didn't do very well. My goodness, they did really well. Our guys did really well. So, Loffler... Ruffler... Cool man, got another kill. And I got a kill, Hans. Lieutenant Hans. And we lost Staudinger and Kirschner and Lutz. Well, Lutz, I think... one of those guys is probably fine. Anyway. Good work, your command is pleased. Lieutenant Loffler awarded Iron Cross, first class. Obsolete Ham joined the squadron. Major Klemperer joined the squadron. Uber Waffle, Burkhalter, Koenig, and Witty joined the squadron. So we got a lot of new people to join us, and I got another kill last time. So yeah, we're doing good. It looks like we're going to be flying another airspace control mission right over the front lines, though. Not so far into enemy territory that we'll need to carry drop tanks. And again, I still can't pick gun pods out here, which sucks, because they're fucking amazing. But next time, July 13th, 1943, about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, good weather for a fight. Obsolete Ham and some Ober Waffles will be flying with me to go and secure the testicles of our shaft. That's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be securing the testicles with me, Lieutenant Hans.